Hello and welcome to Frankly Speaking, Mr. Muzaffar Beg, and many thanks for joining us on the show tonight. You're among the few people, few leaders from Jammu and Kashmir who have had an open mind as far as the abrogation of Article 370 is concerned. At least that's what you've displayed. You've been in touch with the center since August 5th when this decision was taken, and you've also gone ahead and met the delegation of European diplomats when they visited Kashmir in October last. I want to ask you, Mr. Muzaffar Beg, your party and Mehbooba Mufti, your leader, had distanced the PDP from you back then in October. What is your status today? Are you a part of the PDP? Is Mehbooba Mufti still your leader? Do you agree with her point of view?
See, first I must correct you. I was not in touch with the central government on 5th of August, as you suggested. On 4th, there was a all-party meeting at Farooq Abdullah's house, and he wanted my opinion. And my opinion was that since BJP has put abrogation of Article 370 and 35 in its agenda for abrogation, they will go ahead and they will do it. That was on 4th. And on 5th, they did it. So I correct to our record that I was not there in Delhi on 5th. It was my hunch that since they have included the abrogation of Article 370 and 35A, they will redeem their pledge to the nation. The matter is now in the Supreme Court. Whatever the decision of the Supreme Court will be binding on everyone. Now, as a lawyer, I tell you that once the matter is sub judice, it is a contempt of the court for any person to comment on what the result is or going to be or should be. So I respect that decision. I was myself a lawyer in that case where this law was laid down. So the facts of the matter today are that 370 is gone, Article 35 is gone, and unless it is reversed by Supreme Court, it is gone. The issue that we have to confront now is that not only these articles have gone, but we, one of the oldest states in the subcontinent earlier, before the partition, Jammu and Kashmir has been downgraded from the status of a state to that of a union territory. That has certain consequences which have a pernicious effect on the ethnic communities.
You've sidestepped the question because I asked you what is your relationship with Mehbooba Mufti today? What is your status in the PDP? Are you part of it? Are you out of it?
I was coming to that. We are not in touch. I am the chief patron of the party, and I cannot be turned out because I was elected by the General Council. The president takes a decision, but if somebody is agreed of that decision, like they do when Mufti Sahib was the chief patron, she was the president. So the tradition is that if somebody is agreed of the decision of the president, they can make a representation to the chief patron, and then he can consider it on merits. But fortunately, unfortunately, this is the judgment of the government that Mehbooba and I are not allowed to speak with each other even on telephone. So she has exercised her power, and unless a representation is made to me, I cannot prejudge the issue, what should be done or what should not be done. Right now, her decision stands.